Hi, welcome once again. And in our previous lesson, we talked about types of proofs, where we mentioned proof by contradiction, proof by contraposition, and proof by mathematical induction. We took an example on proof by contradiction. In this lesson, I just want to look at another example. So this time, our example two on proof by contradiction. So we have example two. So we want to prove that. So this is the proposition that for a right angle triangle. The length of the hypotenuse is less than the sum of the two other sides. So that's what we want to prove. We are proving that for a right angle triangle, then the length of the hypotenuse is always less than the sum of the two other sides. So diagrammatically, what are we trying to say? We're trying to say that if we have a right triangle like this, well, this place could be C, A, and B. So what the statement is talking about is the fact that A plus B is always going to be greater than C. When C is the hypotenuse, then these are the other two sides. So this is what we want. This is our proposition, or this is our hypothesis we want to prove. And we are doing that by contradiction. And you recall that in contradiction, you need to start with a negative statement. So if this is a statement, then this negative is going to be that A plus B is either less than or equal to what C. So our negative proposition will be that A plus B is actually less than or equal to C. So that is what we want to do. So we're starting from here. Now, from this particular aspect, we square both sides. So squaring both sides will result in, for instance, A plus B squared less than or equal to C squared. Now expanding the left side, then we will have A squared plus B squared plus 2AB, which is less than C squared. Now, something interesting is about to happen. Now, when you look at this, all this is actually less than or equal to this. But it's also possible that we write something like this. Watch. We have A squared plus B squared. Now, we realize that this one alone is going to be less than or equal to all of this. So we are having A squared plus B squared plus 2AB. So this portion alone is less than all this, and it's actually less than or equal to C squared. Okay. Now, having done this successfully, it is possible for us to infer from this that if this is less than this or equal to it, and this is also less than this or equal to it, then we can conclude that this one is less than or equal to this. So we ignore the one in the middle and say that A squared plus B squared is actually less than or equal to C squared. Now this is what we have now. But interestingly, we also know that for a right angle triangle, then A squared plus B squared should be equal to C squared. This was the tedious work done by certain mathematicians referred to us as Pythagoras. So Pythagoras came and told us that, and which has been proven, that for a right angle triangle, so if you square the hypotenuse, then it should be the same as the square of the sum of the squares of the opposite the other two sides, which in this case becomes A and what? N or B. So from Pythagoras, which has been proven, this should be the case. But in our negative proposition, which we are following, we realize that we are having A squared plus B squared, which is less than or equal to this. And in fact, the two can't be the same, because you agree with me that these two signs less than or equal to and equal to sign, they are mutually exclusive. So they can't be equal. But for this one, it has been proven that it is correct. Then we conclude that this particular issue, statement we have arrived at, is false as far as proven mathematics is concerned. So this one is contradicting this particular statement that A squared plus B squared should be equal to C squared. So on this basis, we say that no, we can't hold on to this proposition that A plus B is less than or equal to C, because it is leading us into a false statement, which is against mathematical standards. So rather conclude that in fact, for any right angle triangle, then the hypotenuse, the length of the hypotenuse, is less than the sum of the other two sides. So we conclude that, so we can put it from here, for a right angle triangle, then the length of the hypotenuse is less than the sum of the other two sides, which from the diagram, we say that A plus B is actually going to be greater than C. So proof completed. Thanks very much for your attention. Wish you all the best. Catch you again in our next lesson. Thank you very much.